It's day 16 at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre, the final day of competition in the men's water polo. We've got the gold medal match coming up a little later on, but first, the small matter of determining who will take bronze as Hungary take on Spain. Hungary have had such a fantastic record in Olympic water polo over the years, 9 Olympic gold medals, but they fell short in the semi-finals. Viktor Nagy has been excellent again throughout this Olympic Games. These are familiar names if you watch your water polo. Very experienced, the Hungarian side. Hugo Zalanki in a second Olympic Games. Morten Vamos approaching 250 appearances now for the Hungarian national team. Matthias Pastor has 7 goals to his name in these games so far. Blaž Erlaj into double figures already. Dennis Varga in his 4th Olympic Games needs 4 more goals to reach 50 in the Olympics. Blaž Erlaj, another vastly experienced member of this Hungarian team, who will get over the disappointment now of that semi-final and will look to try and finish with a medal here by trying to take the bronze. Spain had a flawless record up to the semi-final. They'd won all 6 matches before they were beaten by Serbia. So they'll be looking to get themselves onto the podium. Did win the gold medal back in 1996.
Number 2, Alberto Morales. Number 3, Alvaro Granados.
Alvaro Granados is the top scorer, 18 goals, 6 of them from the penalty spot.
Number 5, Miguel de Toro.
Miguel de Toro is closing in on 80 international appearances for the national team.
Number 7, Mark Romero. Number 8, Francisco Fernandez.
These players have performed exceptionally well at these Olympic Games. They only conceded double figures twice. That was in the opening match against Serbia and the semi-final against the same opposition. Very good defensively and a very good in an attacking sense as well. Blai Malarac is the only left-hander in the Spanish team. And number 12, Alejandro Bustos, one of the centre-backs in that very good Spanish defence. Our 2 referees for the bronze medal match come from Russia and from Greece. Arkady Vovodin and Georgios Stavridis, 2 very experienced officials.
And from Greece, Georgios Stavridis.
Difficult job for them, you'll see as soon as the action gets going. If you're not familiar with water polo, most of the fouling goes on under the water. They have a tricky job to keep an eye on things. Those exclusions could be all important today as well. Our 2 FINA delegates who keep an eye on proceedings, and the 2 national anthems to come now from Hungary and from Spain.
And now the anthems of Hungary and Spain.
Hungary to Spain の国歌です。
Thank you. At the end of this match, there will be celebration for one side and heartache for the other. The Spaniards there, they looked great in their early games, beating Serbia and Croatia, but despite leading their semi-final against Serbia, they lost that in an absolute nail-biter in the dying seconds to the defending Olympic medalists. Hungary there, well, they led their semi-final against Greece and they managed to get ahead by one, but after that they were totally outclassed by the Greeks. And despite dominating the sport for the last few years, as you mentioned, Mark, 9 gold medals, they've finished 5th at the last 2 Olympic cycles. They played great in a quarter against Croatia, in fact winning 15-11, and they will sport 3 left-handed players here in this bronze medal match. The Spaniards, though, they've got plenty of firepower. They can manage to score all over the pool, not to mention Manures Agana. It's his second Olympics, 13 gold, and one of the tremendous drivers that we have witnessed throughout this Olympic campaign. So I expect it to be a close one. I don't think there will be much in it. Last time they met was at the European Champs in 2020, and Hungary beat them by 1 goal. I expect it to be just the same here this evening. They'll have to come out, get the nerves out of the way. That's the previous results leading into this bronze medal match. And what they'll have to do is attack first. They'll have to have impeccable defence and try and not have too many exclusion fouls if they're in with a chance to win.
Well, Hungary, as you mentioned, finished 5th in Rio 5 years ago. Bizarrely, they didn't lose a single game in normal time in that competition. They lost on penalties in the quarterfinal to Montenegro. That was their only defeat, but it still goes down as a draw on the score sheet. But you see there that flawless record. Some close ones in there as well. That 13-12 win over Serbia on the opening day. A couple of big wins over Kazakhstan and Australia. And a hard-fought win over Croatia before they beat the USA in the quarterfinals. They were bitterly disappointed to go out in the semifinals. It was a thrilling game against Serbia, just 1 goal in it. But Serbia, of course, as the defending champions, they always knew that was going to be a tough game for Spain.
Thomas March, he'll be in charge of things. He won gold playing for Hungary at the Sydney Olympics and was appointed coach in 2017. Opposing him is David Martin Lozano. He also, as a player, won a silver medal for Spain at the World Champs in Rome and was also appointed in 2017. It's been a long campaign for the coaches and even longer for the players, and it will come down to the next 4 lots of 8 minutes to decide who will remain on the podium and who'll have to watch the celebrations from the sideline.
Nigel and Lopez, the 2 goalkeepers, have been excellent for their side so far. See how they fare today. We're ready for the first swim off in the bronze medal match. It'll be Femera for Spain in the dark blue swim caps and Christian Manhert for the Hungarians who are in the white caps. We're underway. It's probably the toughest match to end up on the losing side is a bronze medal match, because you don't go home with anything, of course. Hungary and Spain will both want to finish on the podium. We saw the Hungarian women put in a great performance in the bronze medal match yesterday. What can their men do here against Spain? Spain's starting lineup. Say Lopez is the goalkeeper. Starting with the 4 drivers and on the first attack. There's an early exclusion foul in at centre forward, so Jancic within 30 seconds is excluded.
So much for the disciplined defence. It's going to be a tricky one.
It's going to be a battle, this. It really is going to be a battle royal, particularly in front of the cage where most of the fouls are committed. And a great score for Munarith to get the opening goal of the game for Spain inside the first minute.
Well, that was outstanding by Munarith. Look at that. That's all the action under the water. The Spaniards had to come out and strike early against this Hungarian side that rolls with confidence. Looked like nothing was happening. In fact, Victor Nudge went one way and then tried to go the other, but it was just too late. Outstanding start for the Spaniards in the opening stage of this game.
Almost a 50% record, 14 goals from 32 shots for Munarith. Spain off and running. in the bronze medal match. All the games in the semi-finals and quarter-finals were relatively tight affairs. Nobody could really build up a head of steam and get a good lead. Spain have had a player excluded here. It's Alvaro Granados. So straight away, Hungary with the extra player attempt to get back on level terms. Working the ball around the cage and finding a way in. It's Manhertz to level it up.
No surprise Christian Manhertz had a go at that stage. He came into this game as the leading goal scorer throughout the competition on 19 goals. It's his second Olympics. It's his favourite part of the pool to shoot from. And absolutely got easily through Lopez Bagnado that time.
Talented family. He's got an older brother, Adam, who also plays for Hungary. Not in the squad here, though, at these games. So trading goals already in the opening minutes of the opening quarter. So Hungary have played in 23 Olympic Games, Spain in 17. They know all about competing at this level. Another shot from Munarith, blocked away by Victor Nagy this time.
His intention is there, though, Munarith. He likes playing in that centre-back role as well. And he's saying, as soon as I get a chance and see a slight opening, I'll have a shot. That time, Nagy was up to the task. But they're attacking early, the Spaniards. A word of warning there for Hungary.
I suppose if these sides take positives out of these games, they're both going to finish in a higher position than they did in Rio 5 years ago. As we said, Hungary finished in fifth after beating Greece. Shot goes skidding over the top off the surface of the pool.
Is there any worse position than finishing fourth at the Olympic Games?
Absolutely not.
It's always a tricky one. Always a tricky one. They've done well to get to this bronze medal playoff. They both came here with hopes of obviously wanting to get through to the gold medal, but that's not the case. That will be contested between Greece and Serbia. Everything on the line at the moment.
So Spain back on the attack. Hungary with another exclusion against Angal this time. So straight away the power play to try and retake the lead here.
This is where they have to score when a player is out. The defence has been outstanding from Hungary throughout this tournament. But when they're down a player, someone has to be open. There has to be something they can create. Maybe in the middle or out wide, but the field defence was up to the task.
They only scored 7 from 17 with the extra player in that semi-final defeat, Spain. Good goalkeepers in the way that we saw Nagy and Lopez in their respective semis called into action on a number of occasions. A little tug back there by Malarak. Hungary back on the attack. Shot from 6 metres, tipped over by Lopez.
Nice shot. Well done. Got the deflection. If he didn't get a hand on that, that was definitely a goal. Still locked up at one apiece at this stage, in the early stages of the first quarter. Both sides looking impressive with the ball in hand. Very good defence is up for the task as well.
Fired off the top of the cage this time. Well, the Hungarians putting pressure on now. It was Denis Varga, the experienced captain.
4th Olympics for Denis Varga. 12 goals in the tournament. He debuted in 2006. He's had a great tournament here for Tokyo 2020. Would love to go home with a medal. It's been a while for the Hungarians. As you mentioned, they won in 2008, but since then they've been absent from the podium. They've worked hard throughout this campaign and they're working hard this evening.
Inside of the post this time from Munarith, who's proving a real threat for the Spanish at the moment. Perone on the rebound, so Spain will keep control of the ball.
They need Perone out there, the captain, 35 years of age. He controls the play in attack and defence. He's the biggest communicator from the Spaniards, and they've got a few. They like to chat and see what's going on, control the play. What can they do here with the shot clock counting down at 15 seconds?
Norbert Hosnianski's just been excluded as well, so they have got the extra player again. Right the way across, that's a wayward ball though, and Spain have lost a few vital seconds. Still managed to get a shot in from 6 metres, but Victor Nagy equal to it.
Uncharacteristic play from the Spaniards then. Their passing game is usually impeccable. Can't afford with a 30-second shot clock. That's all you have in water polo to make the shot in goal is 30 seconds. You cannot afford to pace it and throw it across the face and not have possession. So, as a result, Hungary now on the attack.
Very well organised, the Spanish. Look at those three centre-backs all just staying in a line and trying to keep the Hungarians at bay. Spain have got two players excluded now, so a real chance for Hungary here to utilise some space in front of the cage and put themselves in front for the first time in the bronze medal match, which they do. It's Zielinski, past Lopez, and Hungary now lead 2-1.
Great pass to Zielinski. That's what set it up. He wound it up with the left hand, had to make sure that the defenders would drop off at some stage and then powered it through. Advantage with a slight deflection, but outstanding stuff. And they had to score there, Hungary. Two of the Spanish players out, poolside. If they didn't score, it would have worked against them mentally. They would have thought, how can we not score without a player? So making the most of the exclusion, and Hungary now with a 2-1 lead over Spain in this bronze medal match.
Over 5 minutes played already. It's fairly flown by this first quarter. They were 4-for-13 with the extra player in their semi-final. So like the Spanish, not really converting as many as their attempts on the power play that they would have liked. But Spain into the hole just in front of the cage. There's another exclusion. So it's a first quarter littered with exclusions at the moment. Matias Pastor.
I think it's what we've seen throughout the finals of this competition. The intense is so fierce. There's so much going on. As soon as you look for your centre forward to pass to, anyone bringing him down. Great shot. Great option to go left. Outstanding stuff from the captain, Harani Rocha. Thought he might have gone right first of all, but really, really caught Nodge out that time. That was the exclusion foul. That was what was happening under the water. Lovely pass. Didn't think about it. Oh, great stuff.
Perone at his third Olympic Games. His brother Ricardo played for Spain and for Brazil in the Olympic. The man born in Rio did play for Brazil 5 years ago, Perone, but now back in Spain. I always think it's a strange sport, water polo. You can play for two different countries. You don't get that in a lot of other sports.
Yeah, that's wherever your allegiance is at the time. We've seen it a lot throughout Montenegro, Serbia. Exactly the same as Croatia. His alliance right now is obviously a good save with Spain.
Good save, Lopez. Fired up for this one. His nickname is El Muro, the wall. And you can see why when he makes saves like that.
41 years of age is Lopez. He's the eldest player in the pool for this bronze medal clash. Comes with a whole lot of experience, three Olympic Games, more than 350 matches for his country. Take him a long way. Here we go, breakaway for the Spaniards. They can swim fast as well. This is where they outclass the opposition. Bringing it through is Larumbe Gonfaz. He's got support. Shot clock is counting down though, so they need to set up the attacking play soon.
Yeah, on the counter, Spain. Munarith on the ball, who got that opening goal for them to put them in front right at the start of the first quarter. That's the only goal they've managed so far. Hungary turned around that early deficit. Out to Sanuha. Two players out for Hungary, so Spain with another excellent chance to retake the lead. And simply done in front of the cage, pushed in by Tahul.
How good was that from Rahul Tahul? He got up nice and high in the centre forward position, gave options to his attackers. The delivery was outstanding. That was the counter attack. Lovely pass and didn't think about it. Had two players on him as well. Christian Manchurch was trying to shut him down, but the fist goes up in the air and the scoreboard increases. So at the moment, Spain with a 3-2 lead over Hungary.
It's amazing. If you put a quality ball into the middle, it's like, you know, other sports, you've just got to help it into that, use the pace on the ball. Brilliantly done. Spain do set the chances up very well. They move the ball across the cage. They drag those defenders out of position.
I think they've had the best passing game in the competition out of all men's teams, the 12 teams that started 16 days ago. They're not afraid to pass it and create options. There is an exclusion foul there, so they say goodbye to Lustosh for 20 seconds. The Hungarians might be able to equalise here, but having trouble getting through to the centre forward. Not that time, though. It's tit for tat here, isn't it? End-to-end stuff. Too strong was Harai. 34 years of age. This is all the action under the water. This is why the exclusion fouls are happening. That's where all the energy goes. Lovely delivery, great pass, and excellent execution from the Hungarians.
Balázs Harai was part of that European Championship winning team in 2020. Played in Rio and in London. Fifth place finish. So you look at some of these players, the likes of Harai, 34 years of age, you wonder whether this might be their last Olympic Games and possibly their last chance of picking up a medal. So there's an extra incentive there for some of the more experienced players in both teams.
Yeah, also with the Hungarians, Hosnyanski's, this is his fourth Olympics. The captain, Varga, his fourth Olympics. They must be pondering their future, but right now all they're thinking about is that bronze medal. And at this stage, there's nothing in this match, in attack or defence.
Great ball on the counter. It was a good delivery. It was a good ball by Victor Nagy right at the end of that first quarter. Set up a chance for his team, but Lopez equal to it. So both goalkeepers have had big saves to make in the opening quarter. After the first 8 minutes of the bronze medal match, it's Hungary 3, Spain 3.
Just at the end of the first quarter, nothing in this bronze medal match. Three apiece for Spain and Hungary. The extra player goals looking impressive for Hungary. 3 from 3. They'll continue to try and capitalise every single time a player is sent poolside, which happens to be quite frequent at this stage. The fouls are creeping up for them, though. 6 for the Hungarians and 4 for the Spaniards. We will see towards the end of this quarter, there'll be some players on 2 fouls, and you'll watch them sit it out and hop on the bench, because if they get 3, they are gone for the game, and they do not want to watch the rest of this match, especially at 3 apiece after the first quarter, from poolside and not be involved in trying to win that bronze medal.
So 6 goals in the opening quarter, 3 apiece. All square then as we head into the second. Once again, it'll be Famera in the sprint for Spain and Adelji for the Hungarians this time. Here we go then. First control of the ball could be important. Spain scored very early on in the first quarter after winning the swim-off, and Famera gets there again, 2 out of 2.
So great, isn't it great when you have a swimmer as fast as Famera that can grab that ball for you? Makes such a difference when you attack first. What they don't want to do is lose possession and create the turnover and make the most of Famera's speed.
We've mentioned it a few times, a lot of the water polo players started out as swimmers. That's where they generated their speed from, and then opting to switch to water polo. We saw some great swimmers, the likes of Vali from Hungary and Rachel Fatal from the USA, who invariably win the swim-offs.
I hear swimming coaches all around the world going, no, 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 but it is a case that some swimmers get a bit sick of the swim and like to turn to the excitement of water polo. That was absolutely delightful. Janczyk then with just such finesse and a great opportunity. Lovely just to pop it over the keeper's head. That was outstanding.
I think even Lopez, the goalkeeper, has to acknowledge that was a little bit of quality there from Zilard Janczyk. A little bit of finesse among all the strong arm tactics in front of the cage.
Nice to see the finesse, nice to see a repertoire of shots. It's not always about the 70 kilometre an hour power ball that comes through. That was delicate, delightful, and certainly helped with the scoreboard for Hungary.
Four goals, four different scorers for the Hungarians who are sharing the goals around in the bronze medal match. So Spain, having taken an early lead in the first quarter, have been chasing the game a little bit since. Hungary haven't managed to build up any head of steam, though. Coming in from the angle, Sanuha.
It is interesting. If you can get two or three goals on the opposition, what a difference it makes. Creates that breakaway. Anything can happen in water polo, and the score changes all the time. But in these tight matches, if you can go up two, like Hungary's going to attempt to do now, it'll make such a difference in the momentum of the game. A few changes coming in as well. Tasia's coming in. Also, Roja Tahul. All their attackers for Spain. So they're going to try and outpace the Hungarians and throw the ball around a bit and see if they can get it in the cage.
Turnover foul from Tamás Mezai. So Spain will get the ball back once again and a chance to try and level things up here. Malarak. There's Bustos, who will release the ball and then head into that centre-forward position right in front of Victor Nodge. That's come off the back of Manhurts. Rebound fell kindly for Spain, though.
Meanwhile, the shot clock is ticking down. As soon as the whistle blows, it's stopped. It's on again. Oh, great steal. That's what you want from a keeper. That's aggressive play from the keep to attack the ball. They don't do that all the time. It takes confidence. It can backfire on you, but not that time for Victor Nodge.
Yeah, Roja Tahul was the man in at centre forward, scored that great goal at the end of the first quarter. A little bit more discipline, the defenders, so far in this second quarter.
They have to be, don't they? Can't afford to lose anyone. Not early, not at this stage of the game. They're playing for bronze, they need their best players out there, and defensively, as much as in attack, you need to play your part.
Balázs Erdélye, that was firing over with the shot. They committed six personal fouls in the first quarter. Hungary, all from different players, so no one walking that three-foul tightrope just yet, or the two-foul tightrope, rather. Another Hungary move. When the Spain move rather breaks down, Manhurts with a steal. And now it's Hungary back on the attack once again, looking to give themselves a two-goal cushion.
I like the structure and attack from the Hungarians. They've got a plan. They're trying to stick to the plan. Trying to draw a defender in on some of their strikers. Hadai's coming back in as well. He likes to shoot from afar. They're not shy in shooting the 5 to 6 metre shots. Very difficult to get past Lopez, though.
Just waiting for reinforcements to arrive here, Spain. Now they've got their players into position. That's into centre forward. That's going to be an exclusion for Dennis Varga. So with the extra player, Spain to level things up at 4-4. Crossbar again.
Great field defence. Outstanding stuff from Hadai. They managed to keep possession to Spain, but that's very inspirational to have your field defenders shutting it down. No way through there either for Spain. The referee didn't like what he saw defensively, so Hadai with field defence now. He'll go to the sideline for 20 seconds.
Balázs Hadai, the latest to be excluded for Hungary, so Spain again with the extra player. They haven't really managed to capitalise much just yet. They do move the ball around the cage with some speed. There's that ball into the centre again. And they didn't gather the rebound, and it's pushed in from close range by Dominguez.
Well, Bustos had a go at it first. It was denied by Nodge. Second time round, Dominguez didn't think twice. Grabs it, flicks it, in, goal. Got to be reactive in water polo. The opportunities don't come that often. He did well. And Victor Nodge is saying he was within 2 metres. He's offside. But the referee's totally disagreed with him. And once again, we're locked up in this bronze medal match, four apiece, Hungary and Spain.
had played as a defender up until the 2017-18 season. Miguel de Toro changed to centre-forward then, and he's got a goal now in Olympic Games, and there's a red card for someone here. I mean, someone's been excluded. They'll have to leave the... It's one of the coaches, I think. He will have to leave the pool deck once he's been...
I think that's the official. Nemeth Jolt, yeah.
Well, he will have to leave the deck.
He's leaving behind the clipboard, which has all the information, which will come in handy.
Tensions running high.
Exclusion foul there, so the Spaniards lose Martin Famira, their fastest swimmer, for 20 seconds. The Hungarians will try and capitalise. So we've got the shot clock at 14 seconds.
Two players out for Spain. Advantage pointing towards Hungary at the moment. And again, they've managed to fire away past Lopez in goal. It's Norbert Hosniansky.
Did well. Did great, Hosniansky. Took an opportunity. Didn't have to think twice about it. Opted for the left-hand side. This is his fourth Olympic Games. He scored 26 goals in the Olympics up until this stage. More than 300 matches for his country. So the experience paying off there for Hosniansky.
So Hungary back into the lead. ...3:14 to go in the first half in the bronze medal match. Good defending again.
No way through the middle. That was great defence from Hungary. No way through to their centre forward. They just could not get it to Roher Tahul. He did his best to try and get into position, but it wasn't the case. So that would be a confidence booster. And here come the Hungarians now, looking for a two-goal buffer. They've looked great on the left-hand side of the pool, but no way through that wall of Spanish defenders.
Well, following Zielanki still at the other end that set up that attack, there's another shot block from Matias Pastor, and Bustos will gather the rebound. Another Hungarian exclusion. Pastor. The shot was blocked a moment or so ago, and now he's out the game for the 20 seconds. Spain looking to get level again before half-time. Another foul in at centre-forward, and another exclusion against the Hungarians. It's Dennis Varga. So that's his second personal foul.
They have to score here, surely. Spain, now's your chance. He came in from behind, didn't they? Captain, was it? That was outstanding. Just introduced himself back in the game, took the ball, now racing away.
It's Christian Manhurts. Fernandez didn't get a call from his teammates that they were about to bring that one player back into play after serving the exclusion. Manhurts just flicked it out of his hand as he was about to shoot.
He hasn't had a massive impact on the game, his Manhurts. He's the top scorer in the competition. They've kept him quiet. They've done their homework, have the Spaniards. It's a nice wide shot, but it bounced too early. So much action happening right here in front of the goalkeepers. Incredible defence from both sides, and there's two fouls there against Dominguez. One more and he'll see the rest of this from the bench.
We see the quick change made there by David Martin, with Spain going back on the attack, bringing back in the centre-forward, De Toro. More exclusions for Hungary, who just losing their shape and their discipline a little at the end of the first half. Fernandez looking to make up for having the ball nicked away from him a moment or so ago. Working the opening, working the ball across the cage and into the cage for Munarith for his second goal of the game.
It was great deception from Munarith. They weren't too sure if he was going to pass or shoot. He waited for Victor Nugd to make sure he was committed and started to drop. So much power behind the right arm. Loves playing on that left-hand wing, straight across the top of the head of Nugd.
Just saw the Hungarian women's team, who won the bronze medal yesterday, cheering on their male counterparts. Two from five now for Munarith, got the opening goal of the game inside the first 30 seconds.
The women's team and the men's team managed to train together throughout the pandemic lockdown period, so they know each other very well, know each other's structure and play. Varga there, the captain of Hungary, now with two strikes on his name. They need him out there.
There's still a long way to go. Hungary pegged back to 5-5 once again. Wide of the target once more. Good defending from Spain, just drawing that shot from a long way out.
They are forcing the Hungarians to shoot from out wide, which is testament to great defence from the Spaniards. Lopez Pinheiro also in goal there. His eyes in at this stage. There's nothing that he'll let loose or go through. It's a very close match. Both sides exceptional on defence, but slightly undisciplined, which could come back to haunt them in the second half.
30 seconds to go then of the opening half in the bronze medal match. Another lob shot onto the crossbar by Spain this time.
Quite a good one, Sanahuya. It's quite a nice one. Had eye there, another one with two strikes on his name. So I'm sure the halftime chat from both coaches will say, do your best, do what you can, but let's try and keep you in the game if that's okay. This is a bronze medal match. We need you in the pool.
A shot came in just as the hooter went, but skips wide of the post. So another tight quarter of water polo. Just the four goals coming in that second quarter. At the halfway point of the bronze medal match, it's Hungary 5, Spain 5.
Playing for bronze at the end of the first quarter. It was three apiece, Hungary and Spain. In the second quarter, they managed to score two goals each. So, five all in the halfway mark of this match. Shot saved, impressive from both sides. Two from seven for Nodge and three from eight for the Spaniards. So, they're doing their best in the field to try and make sure the ball doesn't come through to the cage. They'll have to dig deep, though, and keep an eye on that defence. Lots of players with two strikes beside their name. One more and they will be out of the game. That puts too much pressure on the players left out there. Nothing in this bronze medal match at this stage. The coaches know what they need to do. It will be up to the players, though, as we count down to the second half.
Yeah, Hungary have got three players on two strikes at the moment. Matias Pastor, Denis Varga, the captain, and Balázs Hiray. Spain, just the one player with the two personal fouls. That's Miguel de Toro Dominguez. Well, the bronze medal at stake. And a fine goal from Perone in the first quarter. That was the goal that levelled it up at 2-2. Both goalkeepers called into action. Lopez has been superb throughout the whole tournament. Spain, though, working the ball well and scoring some good goals in the match so far.
Doing well to find the centre forward as well. We've seen throughout the quarterfinals and semi-finals, both in the men's and women's, how tough it has been to try and find the players in the middle to try and do their part, but they're managing to do that. Have the Spaniards. Also a beautiful, delicate shot there. Outstanding stuff. We'd like to see more of that from Zilad Janzic. Just 27 years of age, showed such finesse. And also reactive play as well when it doesn't go in the first time round. Just try and pop it in the second. So nothing between these two sides. Just as we expected. The last time they played was in the 2020 European Champs in Budapest, where Hungary just managed to win by one goal. Looking at the performances throughout the finals and also the preliminary matches, we knew it would be close. I guess what it will come down to is something special from one of those players. I'm looking to Christian Manchurch from Hungary to do something in this second half to try and break away from their defenders and create some magic.
Teams have changed then, ends then at half time. So Hungary in the white will play from right to left. Manhurts on the swim off. Femera once again for Spain, looking for three out of three, and he's just going to get there first again.
Oh,
First attack then of the second half from Spain. They scored very early on in the first half after winning the swim off in the first attack from the man on the ball now, Munarith. And he's hit the bar this time.
Not afraid to shoot from out wide is Munarith Agana. I love the fact that Victor Nodge kisses the ball when he saves it. A show of respect to the ball. He's been doing that throughout the whole tournament, and apparently it's brought him some good luck, so he will continue to do it. This side, he's doing very, very well, and Hungary on the attack. Have possession, trying to create something special, trying to break this deadlock against some very impressive Spanish defence. They're moving quickly to the ball, and their field defenders are deflecting the ball to make it so much easier for López Piñeiro.
That was Martin Ferreira who won the swim-off, getting the block in. Christian Manhurt's shot.
He'll be the difference for the two sides. He has to get more involved, Manchurch. He's been outstanding throughout the tournament. We've mentioned he's been at the top of the scoring table, that they've contained him so far. Let's see what he can do in the second half.
Spain haven't led in the game since towards the end of the first quarter. Steal from Manhurts again, so another Spanish attack breaks down and a chance for the Hungarians to put pressure on. Victor Nodge will get them moving.
Third Olympics for Nodge. Loves playing in that goalkeeper role, debuted in 2006. 37 years of age. Hasn't indicated this might be his last Olympic campaign. He has indicated he wants to leave with a medal. Great save, great stuff. Keepers are doing their part, aren't they?
Daniel Angel with a shot and a good save by López. Got across well with a big, strong hand. It's still Hungary's ball, though. Exclusion for Ferreira. So Hungary with the 6-on-5 press now. Working the cage and working the ball past López. It's Martin Vamos that gets the goal.
Looked like there was no way through. A wall of defence. López was nice and high, guarding the cage like it's his own. Got a hand to it, but just too much power on the skip shot. As it bounces off the water, take a look at it in slow motion, just manages to skip underneath the arm of the keeper. They're the toughest shots, those ones. The ones that come off the water and take a different angle. It's a great confidence booster for the Hungarians to score first in the second half.
12 out of 27 for Martin Vamos in the this edition of the Olympics. You can see the frustration from the goalkeeper having got a hand to the ball.
Now we'll see the defence from the Hungarians lift as well. On the back of that inspirational goal, what they need now is to get that possession back and go for two up. What they don't want is what they just received, which is an exclusion foul. Makes things a lot tougher now with the player out for 20 seconds.
Yeah, Norbert Hosnianski is out. Great block in front of the goalkeeper from Zielanki. Good defending again, shielding the goalkeeper. Perone into the side of the cage.
I think both times that was Angle that stopped the ball. First time round with a high hand, second time round with a deflection. It's incredible how high he can get in the water. That time he wasn't even looking.
Need a little bit of luck sometimes. So Hungary back on the attack. Just the one goal so far in the third quarter from Martin Vamos. Hungary leading here 6-5 in the bronze medal match.
This could be a turning point of the game. Right here, right now. Still seconds on the shot clock. And there we go. Loss of possession. The Spaniards will bring the ball forward. That is Ferreira, the best swimmer and the fastest swimmer out there. On two strikes, you're allowed three. He takes a look and says, okay, I need to have a rest and see what I can do maybe in a few minutes' time. They need him out there also to get that first possession on the swim-off, which has been exceptional.
Just caught a glimpse of the scoreboard there. Those yellow numbers down the right-hand side of each team are the personal foul, so they know straight away. Straight onto the head of Victor Nodge from Tahul.
Tahul should have got that. If he could have that again, I'm sure he would have gone right or left, as opposed to right down the middle. And in the southern hemisphere, we call that a falcon. Got to stop it somehow, haven't you?
I just love the reaction from the goalkeeper. He's going, you're not getting past me. You're not getting past me.
Yeah.
Turnover foul once again from the Hungarians. So a bit of sloppy play just creeping into both sides at the moment. It's Dennis Varga there who's on the two fouls.
That'll really frustrate Thomas March, the coach of the Hungarians. They had possession. They did the hard work defensively. They worked on the back of a save. And then they turn it over to the Spaniards, who now have an opportunity to level it. Great open water here. Oh, excellent save from Nodge.
Well, I don't know if that's hit him on the head again.
Whatever it takes.
He's going to need some aspirins, I think, after this. Tensions starting to build in the bronze medal match with 3:28 to go in the third quarter.
Nothing happening in the middle for Spain there. You can see the defender keeping the centre forward down. Nothing at all. Fisco's in the air, the teeth are clenched. You'd refer to that as a double header.
Four saves from nine now for Victor Nodge. Here come Hungary. Still looking to open up a two-goal lead. They haven't managed to do that as yet in the game so far. Nice little lob shot again. Underside of the bar.
It's pretty close. Not a bad option. No one expected it. Not even Lopez. Oh, it was close, wasn't it? I'm surprised they didn't go to the visual aid referee. But back in play, the Spaniards looking to even things up. And now the referee might say, well, take a look at the screen, please, because that looked a little closer than what I initially thought. Yeah, not surprised.
Do have VAR assisting. We've seen a couple of goals given where the ball has crossed the line. A goalkeeper's just clawed it away, but they have adjudged the ball's crossed the line. So we'll just be a hold-up here while Georgios Stavridis goes to take a look.
A nice opportunity for the players to take a rest as well. So much energy would be zapped from this game. They're constantly defending, attacking. The conditioning of these players is phenomenal at this elite level. Here's a replay of that shot. It was deflected on the top. It did look to me as though it entered the cage. That was from the first image before the replay. I'd hate to be a referee, let alone a video assisted referee. Yeah. I do not want that job.
Mladen Rak from Croatia is the VAR official.
Had a hand gesture there, like your guess is as good as mine. Might be a close one.
I think we had one in one of the games yesterday where we said if you can't categorically see it's crossed the line, then you can't give the goal. It's one of those you have to be 100% sure. That's the whole idea of having a VAR check to confirm things.
So unless you can categorically prove that that ball went into the cage, I think they'll remain with 6-5.
And I think Georgios Stavridis is particularly convinced at the moment.
Taking their time at this stage. No fans here at these Olympics, but some of the compatriots of the players have turned up. It's the final day of competition. They've turned out to support Spain and Hungary as they fight for a bronze medal in men's water polo. Here we go. Decision time.
No goal. I think that has to be the right decision. If you can't tell categorically, as we've said, if the ball's crossed the line, then you have to side and stay with the original decision. Do have goal line judges here as well, looking along the line. Sometimes the speed of the ball is so quick, it's even too quick for them. 2:29 to go then in the third quarter.
Turnover here. Here come Hungary. Great opportunity for them to bring the ball up the pool. See if they can set up an attacking play. Decided to go left. It's a perimeter player. Time it is elderly. Doesn't have much support from his players at this stage, but trying to create a break with the swim lane. Trying to get the defenders out of position to create something special. They've gone wide. Good shot straight to the keeper.
Blocked by Lopez. There's a real battle going on in the middle of the pool. between De Toro. Good save, goalkeeper got himself in a good position there to just close down those angles at the near post.
This would be exciting if Spain could level things here with a minute 40 to go before the third quarter break. Four quarters in water polo of 8 minutes each. This stage, we're at the dying stages of the third quarter. Shot clock counting, and they couldn't find the cage.
Just one goal in this third quarter so far as well. It's been about defenders rather than attackers. Malarak it was that time with a shot that was off target. Now Hungary coming forward again. Haven't managed to open up a two-goal cushion yet on Spain. Steal from Shanuha.
Harshnyansky, two strikes, another one. Not ready to bite the dust, so to speak, but has one more opportunity. I'll have to tell him to keep an eye on his defence. They need him out here. He's got lots of experience. It's his third Olympics, but now Spain trying to score with the last minute before we go to the break to try and make it 6-6. There's some opportunity there, not necessarily in the middle. Goes for a wide shot. Doesn't quite sneak it in, and Victor Nodge goes, no, 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 no. You cannot get through me. Likes to raise the finger to the opposing shooter and let them know that it wasn't successful.
Could be a potential of a penalty shootout if it's level at the end of the four quarters. We don't play any overtime. It goes straight to the shootout. Both sides would like to try and win it in regulation time. It's a heartbreaking way to lose a medal match, particularly a penalty shootout. Here come Hungary with 20 seconds or so left on the clock. There's a turnover again. A turnover foul from Balázs Hirai this time. So an interesting team talk for Tamás Marsh at the end of the third quarter. His side have been a little clumsy in their attacking play.
Well, he knows how to win a gold medal. He won one playing for Hungary at the Sydney Olympics. He was appointed coach in 2017, and I'm sure he knows what he wants from these players in the final quarter.
So the tightest quarter so far, just the one goal as that final shot from Perone goes flashing across the face of Victor Nodge's goal. And at the three-quarter point of the bronze medal match, it's Hungary 6, Spain 5.
Well, the keepers have been kept busy. 5 from 11 for Lopez and Nodge 4 from 9. So they're certainly doing their part in the cage. At the moment, just one goal in it, with Hungary leading Spain by 6-5. The counter-attack goals are in favour of Hungary at the moment. 1 from 1. And the team fouls, well, the Hungarians at 13 and the Spaniards at 7. That puts pressure on the coach of the Hungarian team to work out who he will play and when he will play them. Just 8 minutes remaining in this bronze medal match. Both sides will need to dig deep, get some nutrition on, and put in the best performance of their life if they are to leave these Olympics with a medal.
So, 8 minutes to go, 8 minutes away from finding out who's going to be taking bronze at the Olympic Games. Just that one goal. The game has got tighter as it's progressed. There were certainly noticeably less exclusions in that third quarter. Players obviously mindful of the fact that they would have to sit out if they were to pick up the three personal fouls. There are several players that are on two at the moment, so they're not out of the woods just yet. Final swim-off. Femera is 100% so far. 3 from 3. Off we go then. It's the penultimate match of the men's water polo tournament. The bronze medal match. And once again, Spain, perfect record in the sprint start.
What an asset to his team he is. Getting all four starts giving an opportunity to his attacking players, but they need to pay him a compliment, show him some respect by scoring once you receive the ball from the sprint off, which they haven't managed to do apart from that first quarter where they got a nice early goal. So let's see what they can do here. There's no way through the middle for the Spaniards. The defence has been exceptional. They get the ball back, no exclusion foul, and then forced to take a shot, and it goes straight to the keeper. There's the kiss.
Nonch getting across again. It's a quickly taken foul in front. Another important save by the Hungarian goalkeeper. If they could start to find their firepower up front, Hungary, there's another one off the underside of the cage and hasn't gone, and it's Lopez's turn to show some great emotion.
That might be a timeout.
Zielanki has been excluded.
Martin Lozano called a timeout there, an opportunity on that exclusion. Let his players know what he wants them to do. It's been a while since we've seen them find the back of the net. There's some pressure on Spain now.
Solanke's third foul, by the way, so we won't be seeing him again. Underside of the bar. Ball didn't go into the cage, not as close as the one we had in the third quarter where they did the VAR check.
It's a shame for Zielanki. It's his second Olympic Games. Played more than 100 matches for his country. Came into this match with 6 goals. He's an asset to this side, but he will play no further part. This is going to be an absolute cracker. What a game to decide the bronze medal winners at Tokyo 2020.
So Spain with the possession and with the extra player. There will be a new player coming in now that Zielanki's out of the game. He can have exclusion with substitute. Didn't manage to get on the score sheet in the third quarter. Spain, and they haven't managed yet here in the fourth either. Underside of the bar once again.
He liked that one. He was pleased with that save. It was pretty close. He's certainly a menacing force within that goal, isn't he? He takes up so much space. He's so big and so strong. He manages to take up such surface area and can get so high out of the water. Almost impossible to get through him at this stage. Hungary with the extra player shots, 5 from 5.
That's another exclusion for Spain, and it's Hungary's turn to call the timeout.
Thomas March with a few words of wisdom for his team.
Alejandro Bustos is the man that's been excluded for the Spanish. So one timeout left for each team now.
The Hungarians are one of the most successful teams in water polo, the most successful teams in men's water polo. They've won 9 gold medals. Had a run in 2000, from 2000 to 2008, where they won 3 in a row. They know how to win the big matches, although at the last couple of cycles they finished 5th both times. They're on a mission here in Tokyo at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre, a magnificent venue that it is. One of the best, I do believe, although I might be a little biased when it comes to venues. Let's see if that team talk can add some justice to the play.
So Hungary on the attack, the 6-on-5. Which just happens to be the match score as well at the moment. Can they make it 7-5 with the extra player? Working the ball, pulling those Spanish defenders out of play, and they have got another goal. And for the first time in the match, they've got a 2-goal cushion now, Hungary. Vamos with a shot.
Vamos, so happy. It's his second Olympic Games. He scored 7 goals coming into this match. Massive left-handed shot. 3 left-handed players, we mentioned at the start of the game, add such potency to any attacking side, and that time he gets so high out of the water. Worth celebrating. 2 from 2 for the match. I dare say he'll be having a couple more shots at goal. Excellent stuff from the left-hander, and a 2-goal buffer for the first time for Hungary.
We saw the reaction from Thomas March on the side, because the team talk and the timeout worked. Spain now have to close down the deficit. They're going to have a player excluded, though, Hungary, which is going to give Spain the extra man. Poznianski, that's him out of the game as well now. So they've lost another of their experienced players.
They've got two in the middle, so they're looking for Famira to attract their defenders. And maybe Tahul. Famira gets it, doesn't make the goal.
Great save again by Victor Nodge.
Still plenty of time in this game for Spain. That was a great opportunity for them. Very good option. Nullified by the excellent goalkeeping of Nodge. No need for the Spaniards to panic yet. Plenty of time to get two back. What they need to do is stop Hungary from scoring here.
Well, they haven't scored in over 11 minutes now. Spain, they haven't scored at all in the second half yet. And Hungary are starting to threaten. Another shot a second ago just hit the crossbar from Matthias Pastor. Another one off the surface of the pool and off the foot of the post.
How quick was it? I could hardly see it. It was absolutely lightning pace. That's goodbye to Zielinski. Ozniacki, his buddy, will sit next to him, so they'll moan between them about these six fouls that have sent them to the side of the pool. Not much they can do about it now, but watch and hope and see if their players from Hungary can shut down this attack from the Spaniards here. Oh, nice, delicate shot. I'm the man.
He's enjoying himself. Victor Nodge, that's seventh save in the match. And Spain still can't find a way through. So Hungary back on the attack once again. We're inside the final 4 minutes. Good save by Lopez. That's a big save now because of it. If Hungary score again with a three-goal lead, it's going to be very difficult for the Spanish to get back in. But at two goals, you still feel they're in with a chance.
It was a good attempt. 6 metres out, though. Might have wanted to get a little bit closer, I think, the Hungarians there. Once again, it's no need for them to panic earlier. The three-goal buffer will give them such confidence. But the Spaniards here, if they manage to strike, it makes it very interesting indeed. This is the bronze medal match for men's water polo. And the Hungarians have lost a player. So Pastor will swim out. This is where they can make them suffer.
Well, Pastor's out the game as well now. That's three Hungary players that have got three fouls against them, so their numbers are running a little thin now. Spain back on the attack, looking to get a goal back. Blocked in front of the keeper by Manhurts.
How inspirational is that from Christian Manhurts? Came into the game as the top goal scorer. And then, how tremendous was that defence? He wants the goalkeeper position. He wants to take that from Nadj. That was outstanding.
There's Dennis Varga, the experienced captain for Hungary. They need their experienced players to keep their heads now. They're working the ball around and a three-goal cushion now. And they sense there could be a bronze medal on the cards. Daniel Angel with the goal.
Rewarded there, Angel. He earned that. It's his first Olympic Games. One of the new breed for Hungary. Slight deflection makes it so difficult for Lopez. Such strength behind that shot. He loves hanging out on that left wing. It's his favourite place. Look at the shoulders. Incredible. There's a little look of relief and a smile. He gets a break at the moment. Still time for the Spaniards to fight back, but they are running out of time.
Hungary back on the attack and another goal. They'd sacrifice the goalkeeper to put another outfield player on. And Miguel de Toro with a turnover foul. And Dennis Varga in his fourth Olympic Games. And how fitting if that were to be the winning goal of the game, it would be scored by Dennis Varga.
How clever was he? It might have been just too early to bring the keeper forward. It's an interesting rule that has been introduced where if you need an extra field player, the keeper can come out and create the 7-on-6 field players as opposed to 6-on-6, but can't get away from the captain then, Dennis Varga. He debuted in 2006. That's his 13th goal. from this tournament, his fourth Olympic Games, as you mentioned. Such experience, and one of the more popular members of the Hungarian Olympic team, not just the water polo team.
Well, he's on to 47 Olympic goals now as well. Hungary are going to have another player excluded. It's Jancic that's swimming away. Second foul for him. And Spain need a goal. They haven't managed to find a way past Victor Nudge since the second quarter.
That's an exclusion foul there. They're arguing with the referee, not pleased that Dennis Farga has been sent. They must score here. They just can't get through Victor Nagu. It's amazing. His defence has been phenomenal. It's his best game of the tournament. He saved it for the bronze medal match, and we've seen some beauties from him.
Another big save. It's Dennis Farga who is out the game as well now. So the man who scored that goal a moment or so ago, the captain, will play no further part. So they're four players down now, Hungary, off the bench.
The question has to be asked, is it time to watch the clock come down? They've only got 30 seconds to make a shot. Sometimes when you stall and go for defence, you do surrender possession, and it works against you. It has that stage. So it looks as though the Spaniards will get a chance to attack, and they are desperate for a goal right now in this bronze medal match.
Well, it's been frustrating. Lopez has made some good saves, but Hungary have just... Well, they scored four goals without reply at the end of the third and into the fourth quarter. So it's a long time since Spain have found a way past Victor Nudge.
That is testament to the defence. To keep the Spanish side, who has so much attacking flair, scoreless in the second half of a bronze medal match, that is testament to exceptional defence.
Spain's last goal came with a minute to go in the second quarter. Another steal from Martin Vamos gets Hungary away once again. They're just going to hang on the ball now. They don't need to do anything. They can just run the clock down. Well, it may not be a gold this year for Hungary, but it will be a bronze medal. Spain, who had won every match up until that semi-final defeat against Serbia, are going to lose two in a row. It's the toughest game at an Olympics to lose the medal match where you go home empty-handed. Lopez not even bothering to play the ball down. Spain know they've given their all, but they've been outdone by an experienced Hungary side who, with such a great water polo tradition, knew exactly what they had to do to win the game. But it's been based on what was a wonderful defensive performance by the Hungarians.
Time for them to celebrate, and they've earned it. They came here hoping to win a gold medal. They'll have to settle for the bronze, and they don't look too disappointed at all. In their semi-final against Greece, they didn't manage to take the lead at all. They got to a tie but didn't take the lead. They were outclassed in that game, and it took great strength and courage to go back and look on the footage and realise what they had to do to beat Spain in this bronze medal match. And for as we say, there are no fans here. There are some supporters that have come from other Olympic disciplines to watch the Hungarians celebrate and take their rightful place on the podium as they win a bronze medal at the Tatsumi Water Polo Centre.
Well, we said nine gold medals in the past. They had that three Olympics in a row. But that will feel very sweet for them, having finished fifth at the last two Olympic Games. The full-time score in the bronze medal match, it's finished Hungary 9, Spain 5. Spain will be left to reflect on what might have been. Hungary, though, very clinical in their approach, and you'd think they'd won the gold medal by their celebrations at the end. That's how much it meant to them to get back on the podium.
It's been a very long 2 weeks, 16 days of competition with the men's and women's. It's been a long 5 years for these players in preparation. Obviously, the delay due to the pandemic, so the Olympics put off a year. Schedules were disrupted. It's a nice show of appreciation for Victor Nudge. He's very emotional, maybe indicating that this could perhaps be his last Olympic Games. Can't hold back the tears. Showing respect to his players and his players showing admiration to him. So there's confirmation of the score in this bronze medal match. Hungary defeating Spain 9-5. Incredible they managed to keep that Spanish side scoreless in the second half of this bronze medal match. 8 saves apiece for each of the keepers, 8 from 13 for Hungary. And they peppered a little more at Lopez, but he also managed to save 8 from 17. So there we have it. That's how it finished up from the semi-finals. Greece defeating Hungary. That meant Greece secured a place in the gold medal match, and they will take on Serbia. Hungary, with that victory over Spain, means they'll get their rightful place and they will be able to return home as bronze medalists from Tokyo.
Two beaten semi-finalists going head-to-head for the bronze medal match. Spain had been unbeaten up to that semi-final defeat, and it was always going to be a tight game. Hungary got themselves into a 6-5 lead, and Spain just couldn't find a way through in the second half. Victor Nagy was superb in goal, and then from the fourth quarter onwards, that's when Hungary just started to pull away.
There was nothing in the first quarter between these two sides. They finished that first 8 minute stanza 3 apiece. We had a feeling it was going to be a close one as they battled it out for the bronze medal. The second quarter came around, and once again, both the attacking sides only managed to find the back of the cage on 2 occasions. Something happened at halftime, and it was a very different Spanish side that came out to attack the second half. Whether or not it was testament to the defence from the Hungarians that seemed to lift, they had heaps of exclusion fouls, and well, they were dropping off like flies at one stage, but in the end, it was the defensive game of the Hungarians that gave them opportunities in attack, and such relief there for Daniel Angel as he managed to find the back of the cage past Lopez, and they knew the writing was on the wall. And also, wasn't it great to see the skipper there find the cage in his third Olympic Games to celebrate a victory for Hungary? Been a long time since they've been on the podium at the Olympics. They've come 5th at the last 2 Olympic cycles. They showed a lot of respect to their goalkeeper, and they are the champions of the pool today. So bronze for Hungary after defeating Spain 9-5.
So the penultimate match of the water polo, the Tokyo Olympics, is over. There's one match to come, and it's the small matter of the destination of the gold. Will Serbia be winning 2 out of 2? Or will Greece get their first ever gold medal in Olympic water polo? That's coming up a little bit later. The men's gold medal match between Greece and Serbia. But it's Hungary that will celebrate bronze.